Greetings to everyone. We are Team 16 and we are working on the semi-automatic tape dispenser machine under the guidance of Professor Sharanappa sir. We are four: Aishwarya, Chandana, Basavaraj and Srihari. With the reference of the GitHub updation by our team members, we prepared a PPT presentation. The first is the problem definition. This is the survey conducted by our team, and these are the conversation which we had with our clients. From the data we had above, we conclude to design a semi-automatic user-friendly machine which is durable and which work up to 2 to 3 hours a day, and the budget should not cross over 4,000. The next is the function tree and the functional clustering. In this semi-automatic tape dispenser, we have three main functions, that is handling the tape, cutting and the indication. In the tape handling, it includes the supporting the system and the DC motor to roll the tape. Cutting unit. The cutting cutter is held here to cut the required amount of the tape when it comes out, and it is done with the help of servo motor, which is controlled by on-off system. The next is the dispensing and indication, which is done with the help of LED lights and IR sensor. The next is the puck chart. Puck chart is used for selection for the very best design among given. In this puck chart, we have compared four concepts with keeping the second concept as the datum. And finally, we have chosen one of them as the final concept. These are the four generated concepts we have done, and this is the concept we have selected. The next is the virtual implementation, which will be continued by Aishwarya.
So guys, this is Aishwarya H of roll number 849, and I am here to explain virtual implementation of our exploration project. Coming to the 3D model of the entire system of semi-automatic tape dispenser, we have used Autodesk Invento app to design this model. In this model, we have a housing part which is used for the safety and also to put all the parts inside. We also have a tape holder which is used to hold the tape, and in between the tape holder, we do have a DC motor which is used to hold the tape and as well as roll the tape towards the servo motor. And servo motor is used to cut the tape at which length it is desired. And we have also IR sensors where these are used to give some information for the LEDs to blink and when not to, as to give some of the indications such as ending of the tape and length of tape, thickness of tape, etc. And we also have an Arduino board which is used to control the entire system, and we have a wire connected to this Arduino board whose another end is connected to PC or a computer to take hold of the whole circuit. Coming to the circuit diagram of the entire system, we have here used the Circuito app to design this circuit diagram. Here we have used an Arduino board, IR sensors, DC motor, servo motor, LEDs, etc. Firstly, Arduino is used for controlling the system. IR sensors are used to control the LEDs. Servo motor is used to cut the tape at desired length, and DC motor is used to roll the tape holder so that it moves towards the servo motor. Now, coming to the flowchart, and this is done using the Microsoft Word. Here we have start, and when it starts, the DC motor gets on and the rotation of the roller or the tape holder starts, as there is DC motor fixed in between. And another part of this is that IR sensor detects the thickness of the tape, and whenever the thickness of the tape gets reduced, there is a blinking of red light, so that to indicate the changing of another tape whenever it gets over. And coming to the part of roller rotation of the roller, coming to that, then we move to the movement of the tape, and after the movement of the tape, the IR sensor detects the length of the tape, or we also can use a switch on or off so that how much ever desired length can be used. And then after that, servo motor is used to cut the tape. This is called as cutting mechanism, as in this mechanism the blade moves horizontally and then comes back, and this indicates the end of the process, and then we have the stop. Coming to the bill of materials required for this entire system, we have 9 bill of materials required, and part name, we have 4 columns, such as part name, material with which it is made up of, specifications of the part, quantity required. 1. Blade. Blade is made up of metal, and the quantity required is single. 1. DC motor. It is of 12 volt battery, and only one DC motor is required. IR sensors. We require 2 IR sensors, to one to note the thickness of the tape whenever it gets reduced to change the tape, and another to detect the process has got ended whenever the servo motor cuts the tape. We have indicators. The indicators which we have chosen are LEDs. We have chosen 2 LEDs for this process, and batteries, we have taken only one, which is a 12 volt battery, and butter paper we have used one so that the tape do not get stuck in between. And microcontroller we have used, that is Arduino Mega. The specification is AT2560, and only one Arduino is required. Housing is made of acrylic sheet, which is used for tough high strength.
The next is the motor sizing and the battery sizing of the entire system. In the motor sizing, we have to know the number of DC motor used. The first one we use is tape roller. In this, the total mass acting is 0.5 kg and the radius is 2 cm. The torque will be 1.5 kg centimeter. The motor sizing will be 60 rpm. Then second one is roller. In this, the total mass acting is 0.5 kg and the radius is 2 cm. The total torque is equal to 1.5 kg centimeter. The motor sizing will be 60 rpm. For the cutting mechanism, we will be using servo motor. The next is the battery sizing. In this, to find the battery sizing, we have to know number of motors used, current supply, and number of hours. So the battery sizing will be 3.6 ampere hour. The next part is the function and specification of the entire system. The functions are rotation of the tape holder, movement of the tape, rotation of the front roller, sensing process, and the indication when the tape comes out, the cutting mechanism, and indication when the process completes.
Hello, I am Chandana. Now I am going to explain about modulation and simulink part of our project. This part is executed through the software called as Tinkercad. We made a circuit mainly using Arduino board, one servo motor, one DC motor, 2 push buttons, LED and battery. And we return the code such that when we press the first push button, the LED glows and the DC motor starts running. As the DC motor is attached to the tape, the tape starts coming out. When the required length of tape comes out, we can press the second push button for the movement of the servo motor. Here we can see the movement of the servo motor. The servo motor is attached to the blade so that the blade moves and the tape will be cut. After cutting the required number of tapes, we can again press the first push button to stop DC motor.